Hello dear students, welcome to the platform of Teacher Educator. Today we are learning about the activity 2.2 from the unit Visual Art and Craft of your USPY paper. In the previous video, we have learnt about 2.1, its basic information and the manner of writing in the record book. The activity 2.2 is preparation of paper art and artifacts. Craft is about creating two-dimensional or three-dimensional objects using various techniques like folding, cutting, pasting, tearing or any other kind of manipulation as per the creativity of the person. Now, how does paper craft educationally support the students? Dear students, paper is a medium which is relatively inexpensive, readily available and easier to work with. It is also neater to work than paints, dyes and other coloring materials. Paper crafts encourage children to draw, tear, glue and paint along with several other exercises which promote dexterity, developing fine motor skills and strengthen their ability to concentrate for longer period of the time. Whether they are making a flower, an animal, a spaceship or whatever the result of the child's paper craft is, the journey begins with a piece of paper and follows their imagination through the final product. It means it increases the creativity skills of the students. Every decision the children make along the way is developing their creativity and discovering their preferences. As with any activity the teacher or the parents do with children, paper crafts promote spending quality time together. Choosing the project, following the steps and celebrating a goal can all be moments that you can share as a group. Paper crafts also inspire the children to think critically. They have endless possibilities as they work through their project. So, this is an excellent learning opportunity to see how their choices affect the outcome. If they do something well or make a choice that they like, they are likely to repeat it. On the other hand, if they see that a decision did not have the outcome they wanted, they can adjust to improve the next time. Paper crafts can also help in emotional expressions. Their product can give you an insight about their emotional health. For an example, if the child has drawn a face which is sad, it opens a line of communication so that you can ask a question, why did you choose a sad face instead of a smile? At the same time, paper craft also create a collaborative environment where the children can work with the teacher, parent or with peers to meet a shared goal. This collaboration helps them to develop communication skills and gives them common ground with others of their own age. Even children who have different interests can also come together to work on a craft. So dear students, paper craft also strengthens understanding of geometry, develops the problem-solving skills and promotes multicultural awareness. Beyond these benefits, engaging a child in a paper craft can certainly spark joy and promote new concepts through various forms of paper crafts like origami, flowers making, paper cards, models, paper cutting, scrapbook making, decoupage, paper mache and many more. Traditionally, origami does not include the use of glue, tape, any marks or scissors. The idea is to create a figure by folding a flat piece of paper with no additional tools used. The most popular origami shapes are animals and flowers. Some samples of the origami can be seen here. Paper flowers are a beautiful decoration. You can create flowers using origami skills or through other methods like cutting individual petals, sticking them together, then adding other attachments with them. Paper flowers can be made on 2D surfaces or using crepe paper, etc. Card making is exactly what it sounds like, an art of making greeting cards. The cards are typically made with a blank card, ruler and glue. The most popular handmade cards are birthday cards. The most rewarding thing about self-made cards is that giving them to someone makes them feel special. It shows that you have been thoughtful and put in extra efforts to congratulate them on that special occasion. A variety of paper cards can be made using your multiple creative skills. Here are some of the samples. Paper models are made using a single sheet of paper into a 3D model by cutting, folding, and pasting. These paper models are hollow from inside. They are made from 2D paper templates by cutting, folding, and then pasting together. You can see some samples: animals, building models, some vehicles, and some cartoon characters. Decoupage is an art of gluing paper cutouts onto the objects. The most common items to decorate include vases, bowls, pots, boxes, furniture, bottles, and plates. The tools needed for decoupage are pieces of paper, scissors, and glue. Decoupage papers are the papers created specifically for this art form, but you can also use cutouts from magazines, origami papers, wrapping paper, and other types of papers. A special glue is needed to stick paper cutouts on different surfaces. The most common decoupage glue is Mod Podge. These are some of the beautiful samples of made using decoupage. Paper cutting is an art of cutting the paper in different creative ways to get a decorative pattern. Here, there are some of the samples of paper cutting. Scrapbooking is an art of documenting personal memories by adding photos and memorable moments to the book pages. Scrapbookers use pretty embellishments to glue or tie to the album, like stickers, ribbons, beads, some sequences, stamps, or wherever their creativity takes them. Digital scrapbooking is a relatively new form of scrapbooking that emerged in the digital age. Digital scrapbooking is a form of paper craft that involves digital tools and computer software. Digital scrapbookers usually use applications like Creative Scrapbook Assistant or Photoshop. Here is one more sample of the scrapbook. Paper mache is one among the simplest and easiest way to make paper craft. The raw materials used in making paper mache articles usually include newspapers, methi or fenugreek powder, multani mitti, or clay. Paper mache is a popular crafting technique which uses paper and a paste to create a variety of objects. As the paper dries, the outer shell hardens, which can then be painted and decorated. So here, there are some of the ideas of paper mache. Dear students, that's all about the paper craft activities. Now, there is a procedure to write this information in the record book. So, as you can see here, first you need to write the topic, then meaning of paper craft, title of the model made, material used, and the technique of paper craft. Which technique you have used or which kind of paper craft you have used, then defining the same, writing its meaning, and finally ending your report with writing the procedure of preparing your model. So dear students, that is all about your activity 2.2. You can choose any of the items explained in the video and create your paper craft work. Thank you. Happy learning.